Hello and welcome to this lecture. Today we are going to discuss about some important multiple drug regimens. And if you take a look of the slide, I have presented a few drug combinations and we have abbreviated them by taking the capital word of each drug. Like when we talk about MOPP, it is used for the treatment of Hodgkin lymphoma. So M stand for methylchlorethamine, O stand for oncovin, P stand for prednisolone, and P stand for procarbazine. So the regimen, the name of the regimens are given by the words or alphabets, especially the first alphabet of each drug. So there are different regimens that we have been given here, like ABVD. Some of them we already discussed in our previous lectures in some case studies. Like in ABVD, it is also used for Hodgkin lymphoma. So A stand for adriamycin, B stand for bleomycin, V stand for vinblastine, D stand for decarbazine. We already discussed this regimen before. Then we have few more like CMF and CAF. So the names are according to the first letter of the drug. So you can take a look of, for a treatment of breast cancer, we can give CMF and CAF. And then we have at the end some more combinations. Then we have ALL, which is acute lymphoblastic leukemia. A stand for acute, L stand for lymphoblastic, L stand for leukemia, and that consists of vincristine, prednisolone, aspergine and donrubicin. Then we have AML, which stand for acute myeloid leukemia, which consists of cytarabin and methotrexate. So if you see different regimens that have been used for the treatment of different cancers, and sometime if one combination does not work, then we need to give the other combination. Why there are different combinations? Because sometimes some therapies are effective for same disease but not effective for everyone. So if for example a woman having breast cancer, maybe the therapy that has been given initially is not effective. So we need to try different combinations, because the main thing is that we need to see that the drug will produce complete remission. If complete remission is not there, then we need to change the therapy. What is meant by complete remission? In simple words, complete remission is that there is no symptom of the disease like breast cancer or leukemia. So we need to see that the drug will produce complete remission so that there will be no disease left. But if the response is partially, then we need to see the other combination, because we already discussed in cancer chemotherapy, even a small quantity or small amount of blood cancerous cells, if they are available, as we discussed that even 1 gram is equivalent to billions of cells. So if a small quantity or small number of cells is available, they are still able to replicate, and then they can cause the disease again. So the successful therapy is based upon complete eradication of the disease, which is important. So the point when we talk about new therapy regimens or development of new therapy, the efficacy of the drugs or drug combinations is very important. Then the second thing that is very important to understand is the toxic effect. As we discussed several times before, that if we are giving the drugs in combination, we need to know that sometimes these drugs have similar toxic effects like nephrotoxicity. If you see the drugs, we already discussed the adverse effects, and most of drug adverse effects cause myelosuppression, alopecia or nephrotoxicity. So if the multiple drugs that have been using combination having same toxic effect, then the toxic effect will be combined and then there will be high toxicity. And that is why patient nephrology or patient kidney must be monitored before giving these drugs to minimize the adverse effect. And the doctor always try to use such combination that having minimum toxic effects, as organ failure is very common when cancer chemotherapy is given. So that is why it is very important. Then the third thing that is important is optimum scheduling, as the schedule, at how many days or cycle of a drug is required. So long cycles is also not good, because they have a negative effect overall on the body and may cause a target failure, can affect the bone marrow. So the optimum dosage, schedule and drug combination at constant consistent level intervals, and there will be a gap between different cycles, is important. Then the interaction between different drugs, before giving the drugs, the physician must know the mechanism of action of that drug, because if it may not overlap or it may not cancel the effect of both drugs. So this is very important to understand the mechanism of action of the drugs before giving them, for producing maximum effect and for eliminating the tumor. And then the fifth advice is to avoid the arbitrary dosage changes. And what is meant by arbitrary dosage changes? Mean that a sudden change or increase, a sudden increase or decrease in dose can be dangerous. So a sudden change is not required. The dose must be consistent, and we need to calculate the dose depending upon the tumor. Or for example, if we add less effective drugs, it is also affect the combination or the cure of the disease. So there are some standard therapies, that few of them I mentioned here, but if these therapies are not working and we need to try a new combination, then we need to see the mechanism of action, we need to see the dose calculation, we need to see the adverse effects, we need to see that there is no drug and drug interaction, we need to optimize the scheduling, we need to know the cycle, the gap between each cycle, how much time we need to give them the drugs, we need to monitor the toxic effects, and these all factors are important when we talk about multiple drug regimen. So thank you so much for today's lecture. Hope to see you again.